Basically, this is the intro for my skateboarding documentary. No special effects, no lights, camera, action sort of thing. Just something I wrote on a bit of paper.
Eric in Paris, Peruvians, ducats, squads.
Skateboarding is a global phenomenon with an estimate of 12.5 million of us doing it around the world. If you think what you are about to see is a film documenting the history of skateboarding, you would be wrong. Go watch Dogtown and Z-Boys. The film you are about to see is about skateboarders' opinions and their way of life to try and put an end to bad vibes and negative stereotypes about the culture I've been a part of since age 11. And you sound too old for this. Go and kick a ball, old man.
Dave's done. How long have you been skateboarding for now?
About 7 years.
What could you say about how deep your voice is just then?
I've been skateboarding for 7 years now.
A year and a bit.
7.5 years.
About 5 to 6 years, around that period.
Far too fucking long.
What could you say about how skateboarding brings people together?
It just does. Like, it doesn't matter who they are or what else they do. It's just skateboarding. It's just a sport that brings people together.
Okay, jump.
I land the most. Man.
Do it.
Well, it's like people who like football and that, like, they usually get on, same with skateboarders, like, we all do the same things, and like, we have respect for what each other's doing, because they have like a different approach on it and that. Like, they'll like say, like, one of your homies may be able to like do a flip a certain way, which you can't do, and you'll be like, yeah, that's dope or whatever, that's it. Like, it's real good, man, it's like, proper impressive seeing your mate do that, and you just hype each other up, really, and that. It's all good.
Well, most of my mates nowadays have like come from the skateboarding genre, and like that's how we've all met and stuff, and then we've like brought it through to partying and that, and just getting on with each other, I suppose.
How does skateboarding have an effect on culture? Example, fashion, music, art, filmmaking, etc.
Yeah, it definitely influences people's styles and stuff. Like, you could tell if someone's a skateboarder if they're walking past and that. And I don't know, there's like a grace about skateboarders. They don't mean harm or nothing, but they'll stand up if trouble comes their way.
I mean, like, so many, like, when you're skateboarding, like, I've always got my iPod on me, you know? Like, that's what drives me to skate, listening to different music, whether it's hip-hop, rock, anything, man. Like, you just appreciate it all, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? And it's not just music, it's like fashion. Like, you still, I mean, there's like some people are conscious how they dress, you know, but like skateboarding, it's like you just like wear what you want, man. It's like individualism, not everyone's dressing the same, everyone's got their own style and flair. Like, same with art as well, like skateboarding can influence art, like, so, like you get like these like graffiti art, like this sort of like new wave modern art sort of thing.
Good style skateboard.
Like fashion, normal skateboarder fashion, it's like a pair of jeans, t-shirt, hoodie, music. You got your like stereotypes, like most skateboarders are into like hip hop, and you get the occasional like metalhead.
Matt here under Matt.
Yeah, like me.
Would you say travelling is essential as something like skateboarding?
Yeah, it really is, because I know, you get bored of the places in your own town or city or whatever quite easily if you've skated it thousands and thousands of times. So if you go travelling, everything's fresh and new and you just get to check it out and try new stuff at different places. Like say there might be no 10 sets in your town, so you might travel just to skate that, and you'll just also get to meet skaters from other towns and cities, and you'll have more like, what's it called, connections from towns and cities through skateboarding.
Definitely, I reckon, and that's the good part about it. Like, you can go to places like London and that and get your face recognised just through skating and meet loads of new people.
So just so you can go to different places and different spots, otherwise you just get bored.
The trains are a godsend.
With all the energy that goes into skateboarding, is chilling important, and how important is it?
I've grown up in a small town called Trowbridge, so we got this little boat we normally sit in and have a couple of beers, and it's definitely essential just to relax. You can't skate 24/7. You need to like chill out every so often.
How do you chill?
You sit down.
Sit down. You're chilling now.
What's the ring back number? 1371.
You're chilling now.
It's 147.
Explain what you're doing now. Explain what you're watching.
Skipping section.
You're watching a skateboarding video. You're skipping the section.
Wait, it ain't
1371.
It's 1471. It's 1471. No man's gonna get me down.
Do you ever get confused with Julia Roberts and Sandra Bullock?
Not. Yeah, all the time.
Can't serve ever. Yeah, go for it, David.
So, Andy, how's your set coming along at this pub?
It's getting a bit tedious now.
Are you bringing out the banjo?
By a chance, is DJ Dick Stroker supporting you?
Stroker's been and gone now. It's all about Zaylo.
Zaylo's.
And Annie Mac down in Fabric.
Is that Andy McDonald?
And birthday? Foster's in Magnus bottles.
How would you say skateboarding is portrayed, and are there any positive and negative stereotypes?
Well, skateboarding can be portrayed as positive, like, and shit, depends, like, really, but a lot of people also associate with criminals and that, and vandalism, and, like, because, like, coppers and that come over, like, oh, you can't skater, and all that, like, trying, like, coppers and security, like, getting all pissy at us and that, like, it makes us look bad, and like we get, sometimes when you're going down the road, like when I'm going down the road skating, like a lot of people like move out of the way and that, like as if, you know what I mean, if I'm going to cause trouble because I'm on a skateboard and that.
Skateboarders, aren't they obsessed with toilet humour?
The guy with the best NAS gets his armpit licked.
Yeah, Brandon. How do skateboarders look at things differently? An example of this would be how a skateboarder uses a bench differently to a non-skateboarder.
Well, put it this way, walk through the centre of Bristol, you will look at everything completely different to everyone else. You'll see a set of stairs and think it as an obstacle to get down rather than someone to walk down.
It's pretty fun. Like benches as well, normal people would sit on them, like do. Skateboarders sit on benches too, don't get me wrong, like a lot of people might think, oh, skateboarders just grind and slide benches, but nah, we sit on them too, but we do grind and slide them as well. We have like fingers for skateboarders and normal people, like people who don't skateboard it. Skateboarders with a bench have lots of things they can do on the bench. All other people do is sit on it, so you know, we're making more use out of it, so we should be rewarded. But what happens? You get told, oh, you're vandalising it, ruining it for everybody else. Well, we're sitting on it fine with it being ruined, we're not complaining.
Where's Bondi?
Explain what is meant by sessioning a spot and how it pushes people to perform better.
Sessioning a spot is when a whole crew, for example my crew, the TSCrew, would like hit up a stair set or something, go to a stair set, yeah, represent, hit up a stair set and just be like, we'd all be skating it at once, trying loads of different tricks to each other, and just trying to push it, like we'd be trying harder and harder tricks, and like we'd hype each other up and we'd be like, it'd make you want to go more all out, do you know what I mean? Like say if somebody kickflip, say a 6 out of 10, it'll be like, yeah, I'm gonna backside flip it now, and it'll be like, yeah, I'm gonna try a switch backside flip down out of 10. Or a nollie heel, or like, you know, if you're gonna be real crazy, some shit like switch tray or fakey tray. Or do some Dave Butlin shit, I don't know.
What have been your worst injuries in skateboarding?
Oh, yeah, man! Have this one.
Have it, son.
Have it.
I remember, like, when I first started out, like, one of the worst injuries I ever had. Like, it sounds ridiculous, but, like, falling over a skateboard off a curb, like, as I was starting out, and, like, just, like, going for it, clip it, and just head smack into the concrete, like, less concussed or something, like, in such days, like, the biggest headache I've had in my life to date, I swear, like, I don't know, like, some of the headaches I have when I wake up in the morning after, like, too many shots, I guess, but that's, like, the worst headache skateboarding ways, I'd say, like.
Broken leg. Ouch.
Probably a week ago when I had my heel bruise, skating an unfinished skate park, just hit my heel in the same place twice, and it's, like, sending pains up my leg, which isn't very pleasant.
Oh. I don't know, I broke my foot twice.
Not liking the sarcasm.
Martin mended it.
Yeah. In a week.
It was good as new. I could go jogging again. Can we do that?
You're the interviewer. Shut up.
I went for a 100 meter sprint after that.
What'd you do it in?
10.1.
Was it egg and spoon?
Nah, I had some big boots on.
Skipping mark.
Some wellies on.
Was what?
Wellies. Dave's on fire.
Was it William's Wish Wellington?
What the fuck?
In the windshield, so bring your friends, but you can think twice, cause I got more rhymes than a 5-pound bag of rice. I'm hitting hard, oh word, I'm gon' rock it. Once the shit drop, that's dough to the pocket. I cut hand, you still can't get no pause. You couldn't deal with school if we was playing cards. But if I got beef, then it's time for cold red. My gun is like a hoe, it be taking mad niggas to bed. So hurry up and skedaddle. Even if you join the army, you still couldn't battle. So where you from?